Zed Zelich and Aurelio Vidmar in the starting 11 from the other night. And for Tahiti, three players making their debut, two of them in defence. And amazingly, the coach was only appointed 3 weeks ago for Tahiti. So they're in a bit of disarray as the match gets underway here. And it's Australia playing from right to left in their familiar yellow shirts, of course. And Tahiti in the all-white. Nine changes in this lineup. And there is one of them, Matt Bingley. Robbie Ennish is playing in the anchor role in the centre of midfield tonight. And with me to look at the future 90 minutes here is former Socceroo captain Charlie Yangon.
Oh, good evening. It's going to be an interesting game, I believe. It's good to see that Terry Venables has given all the players the opportunity. As you see, a break forward by the Socceroos. I think they're going to be playing a little bit more patient. I don't think this lineup is going to be the main lineup that he's looking at. I think the last game that he had with the Solomon Islands, you'll find the majority of the players will be part of the first 11. But it's good that he's giving all the players the opportunity. And he's still feeling very, very confident by the fact that he's made nine changes to the game. But again, the nine changes and some of the players that have come in are magnificent players, and I'm sure that's going to be an interesting game.
The referee tonight is from New Zealand. Brian Precious is the man in the middle. Australia come forward with Robbie Ennish, Paul Trimboli, Bingley down the right-hand side. Free kick to Australia. Matt Bingley so impressed Terry Venables in the Four Nations tournament in January. And so many of Australia's goals, if you like, in that particular phase came from wide midfielders like Robbie Hooker and Bingley, and Alistair Edwards came on as a substitute and scored against South Korea as well. It was a different story the other night somewhat. The two central strikers getting 10 goals between them out of the 13. And tonight it's Paul Trimboli and Graham Arnold up the middle for the Socceroos. Musket goes back to Jelko Kalas. Kalas and Bosnich resuming that competitive situation that they've had for so many years in so many Australian teams. Both looking to be Australia's number one. Free kick to Australia. First yellow card of the game, coming very early on in the game. The number eight, Vishu, for Tahiti. Australia assisted the other night, of course, with the sending off of one of the Solomon Islands defenders in the first few minutes of the second half. The free kick comes in. Everyone leaves it, including the goalkeeper, and Bingley working his way in at the far post, couldn't get there. And what a season this man has had. Robbie Ennish really has reached his true potential that he's been promising to do for so many seasons. He's expected to move to Portsmouth very shortly. Alongside his goalkeeper tonight and his Sydney United teammate, Jelko Kalas. Tahiti forward down the left. Very much an unknown quantity for us tonight, Charlie, the Tahitians. They have not brought many players from the side that came here in November, and they were only really thrown together 3 weeks ago by the new coach, Richard Vincent.
Well, it's going to be a tough one, Paul. I think, you know, the fact that we don't know too much about them is one thing. I think if you have a look at the calibre of our players against the Tahitians, and no disrespect to the Tahitians, but I think what we should be really focusing on is the way this combination is going to be playing, as we see an offside there. I think the thing that we've got to look at is the way the 11 players for the Socceroos can combine together. I don't think this lineup's played together before. So it's also important for these players, as you mentioned, there was nine new players in this particular lineup. All of them are going to have to try to produce something. We saw from the last game that, you know, the strikers have both scored five goals each, so, you know, there's going to be a little bit of pressure on the boys that are out there to make sure that they start putting some runs on the board for Terry Venables. So it'll be good to see if we could have a start like we did against the Solomon Islands. We get an early goal and hopefully put a lot of more pressure back on the Tahitians.
it's very much the feeling of a trial game still for some of these Australian players. They are all so determined to do well and make the final squad of 22 for the New Zealand games and then the Asian games, hopefully after that, and then hopefully France after that. As Vidmar goes through the centre, he'll get there first. Hooker in support. Ned Zelic helping out Robbie Hooker. Here's Zelic. Trimboli, Zelic again. Couldn't take it with him. Tahiti come away. That's a good long ball. Kalat coming out all the way. Just a simple pass from Jelko Kalat to Robbie Hooker, and Australia can start again with Zelic. Gary Venables very pleased with the performance the other night of Ned Zelic in that holding role in the centre of midfield. Mel Blanco's assistant coach just to Gary Venables' left there. Craig Moore. Graham Arnold. Very quick bit of tackling there on the number three, Rex Fauda. Despite the fact they've brought 10 players with them to Australia who haven't played for Tahiti before, quite an experienced side that's taken the park at the end. As the cross comes in, it's a corner to Australia. Players in their mid to late 20s with the three debutants, two of them in defence. One of them is the number 15, Sylvain Boen. Australia, their second corner of the game. Bingley trying to get there, he can't. Aurelio Vidmar, captain for Australia tonight. Trimboli, Vidmar, Zelic. Didn't have time to line one up. Trimboli working his way through, but the Tahitian defence just cleared the ball away. It'll be interesting to watch Aurelio Vidmar tonight with the captaincy back. He seems to be a different player when he's got the armband on, certainly in front of goal.
I think, Paul, there was a little bit of criticism based on probably the way he played in the last game against Solomon Islands, but Aurelio Vidmar is an absolute magnificent player, and he's the type of player you always look to try to have in the squad and in the starting lineup, and he can create a lot of things and score goals, which is important breaking forward. Unfortunately, he wasn't on the list the other night.
We'll see Graham Arnold his way in. Luke Paul here, over the bar from Enish, when it was laid back delightfully for him. He's a player who scores some marvellous goals, but he doesn't score a lot of goals, Robbie Ennis. And that was a good opportunity to open the scoring for Australia.
It was a good build-up, great ball by Graham Arnold. The Tahitian defence didn't clear it, and Robbie Ennis coming in trying to play with the outside of the foot.
It was an ambitious try, taking it on the outside of the right foot, but a poor clearance there from the number seven, Aura. That Australia had the other night, but they're still well and truly dominating. Arnold through the centre, got the shot in, just past the post. Well, if there is a player in the Socceroos side tonight that really wants to make his mark in front of goal, it's Graham Arnold.
You see here a great attempt, a bit unbalanced, and try to poke it through. But again, this player, Ned Zelic, his involvement is so critical for the Socceroos. It's a good ball in there. Graham just wide of the post. But what we're seeing the difference so far, even though it's early days, is this particular team's playing a little bit more patient. They're trying to keep possession, and the momentum's not the same as the previous game. But all credit to the Tahitians so far. They've kept their Socceroos trying to play in the middle. Here we go again, trying to play forward through the middle. And the Tahitian players seem quite strong and quite big. And I think the tactics of Terry Venables will be looking at. We'll be trying to get behind the defence again. And this is where we're lacking. I don't think that we've started in the right mode. You've got Robbie Hooker, who's not necessarily a left back, an overtaking left back like Stan Lazaridis. But I think they've just got to keep patient, keep working the ball, and try to get it wide as much as possible.
Vidmar over the top, Trimboli now. On the volley, but couldn't keep it down. And Aurelio Vidmar involved there, but it was Paul Trimboli at the point of the move. It was a difficult ball to keep down. He struck it with some real power, but was just leaning back a fraction, and the ball sailed over the bar. So Australia have had some good moments in attack, but thus far the Tahitian keeper Ricky Fassant has yet to make a save. Moore leaves it for Ivanovic. Australia begins straight away. So often in these sorts of games the players can struggle to get motivated in certain ways, but with so much at stake in terms of places in the squad, there'll be no slacking off from this 11th set of players. It's a new team from the other night, of course. A new chance to impress. Finish in quickly. Won the ball back for Australia. Trimboli takes over. Good ball to the back. Arnold in there chasing. Oh, straight at the goalkeeper from Hooker, who had to react quickly there. The goalkeeper was well off his goal line, but Hooker took the volley first time.
Great ball in here by Paul Trimboli, digging for Graham Arnold. And it's unusual you see an attempt like this. We saw the keeper back at, straight back into his hand. But I still feel, Paul, it's important that the Socceroos start looking and getting the play wide. At the moment, they're playing too forward, too straight, too direct, and they have to try to get behind the defence of the Tahitians.
One of the Tahitians is down currently. The number 15 for Tahiti, Sylvain Boen. He'll go off to get some treatment. Australia will resume with Robbie Hooker. Accordingly, gives the ball back. Straight through the goalkeeper. A nervous moment, in fact, for the goalkeeper. We've had 12 and a half minutes of game two for Australia here at Parramatta Stadium. They haven't quite got off to the same start as the other night against the Solomon Islands. It's still 0-0. Certainly in terms of possession, Australia are really dominating this first half here. Paul Trimboli has had one volley go sailing over the bar. And Aurelio Vidmar and Graham Arnold also well involved, as the Tahitian keeper, Ricky Fassant, has just gone down for some treatment. It's the second time of the game that that's happened, so he's already feeling a little bit of pressure here. The Tahitian defence so far holding out here at Parramatta Stadium. Ricky Fassant, one of the more experienced players in the Tahitian lineup. He played against Australia back in November. He's the number one goalkeeper for Tahiti, but he's in a bit of strife here, and we might just see here what happened. Perhaps he pulled a muscle when he kicked the ball out. Well, he just seemed to hobble for a second there, and he rolled it out and then went to ground. So it doesn't look good for Ricky Fassant. There was no one near him. Had a bit of treatment from the Tahitian trainer. The reserve goalkeeper is Jimmy Takotini. He's never before played for his country, and he's 19 years old, and he's warming up on the halfway line. Looks like he's ready to come on. Just prepared to wait and see how Fassant goes. Saying perhaps give me 10 minutes and see if I can just work it off. Well, we saw Australia get a significant advantage the other night when the Solomon Islands had a player sent off, and if Tahiti had to substitute their goalkeeper so early on in the match, it would be another bonus for the Socceroos. Cleared by the defence. Must get underneath it. Tahiti forward, flags up, only just though. Calaf's off his line quickly. And they just looked a little bit out of shape there, the Australian defence, Charlie.
Yeah, they certainly were, Paul. If you have a look at the makeup of the back line, you've got Kevin Muscat playing on the left-hand side. I can't recall him playing in that particular role. I know he's played as a centre-half before, but playing on the left-hand side, and Milan Ivanovic and Craig Moore as a combination. Obviously, it takes a little bit of time for them to settle in. This is one of the things that we have to be very careful of. We talk about the Tahitians or Solomon Island players. Occasionally they come and they can break forward in circumstances like this. If somebody gets caught out, they can easily counter-attack, and they've got to be careful with Socceroos that they don't go one goal down out of nothing. So it's very important that they keep the line, the makeup of the play. As we see Paul Triboli breaking forward. Bingley takes over. Cross was blocked. Bingley again, this time trying to find it to the near post. Again, Tahiti deal with it through Bowen. They look long. Australia cut it out quickly. Lengthy forward for the Socceroos. Zelic takes over. Vidmar waking his way into the penalty area. Now the ball comes. Vidmar unchallenged. Great goal. Aurelio Vidmar. Well, what a way to answer. I say critics hesitantly because there was some comments about his performance the other night, but that was a first-rate goal against any opposition, and it was engineered by the long ball from Zelic in midfield. Yeah, as we can see, Ned Zelic, what magnificent vision, plays a magnificent ball in. The defence was caught flat, and Aurelio Vidmar, magnificent header.
Well, it's something about that armband, Charlie. I don't know what it is, but when he's wearing the white cloth on his left arm, he comes up with things in front of goal that few players in the Australian squad can do, and that's a perfect example of it there.
Well, it wasn't an easy header either. He was running backwards, and he got up very well and put it into the far side of the goal. A magnificent start. Again, the Socceroos being very patient in their build-up, and it was a great goal. Aurelio Vidmar, again, he's one of those players that puts everything into performance that he has for the Socceroos.
The news for Tahiti is not good. Not only have they just gone a goal down, but their goalkeeper, Ricky Hassan, has gone off. And Jimmy Tahitini, who's just 19 years of age, hasn't played for his country before, and he's here now against an Australian side that's hungry for goals. Well, he can either make a huge impression in his debut, or just be overwhelmed by the occasion, and we shall see which way it goes. Tahiti trying to come forward now. Uepeti, number 19, big striker for Tahiti, just winning the free kick. One in the air by Muscat. It's Bingley. Craig Moore. This is Craig Moore's first game under Terry Venables. He was unavailable for a couple of games in Europe against Hungary and against Macedonia. There was some talk that he may have burned his bridges, but that's not the case. He's here playing tonight. He has every opportunity to show just how good he is and how much he's improved at Glasgow Rangers. Vidmar tries to turn and is beaten. No, free kick. Foul by Olivier Dexter. To get on with the game quickly. Back to Zelic. That's still in play. Bingley prepared to chase it too, which tells you how much Ned Zelic did miss kick that ball. He's not known for goal scoring prowess. Scored just once for Australia, and that was in the last World Cup campaign in 1993 against New Zealand at Olympic Park.
One thing we've noticed so far is that the pace of the game is so different from the one the other night. And I think the credit has to go to the Tahitians. They've organised their defence. They're all getting behind the ball. And they're making it difficult for the Socceroos to try to break through. You see, they have a lot of numbers behind the ball. And even now, they're not afraid to play. The occasional ball that they try to play, unfortunately, the final pass is a little bit too ambitious. But if they start to believe in themselves and start playing as a unit, knocking the ball around, then they may, you know, put a little bit more pressure on the Socceroos. And they've got to be very careful that they don't get caught on the counter-attack. As you can see, that the play at the moment seems to be very slow. The build-up's quite slow. The Tahitians are getting a lot of players behind the ball. And we've just got to keep moving. The movement's got to be all over the place and make it a little bit more difficult for them to get organised. As we can see now, they all are behind the ball. It's good possession by the Socceroos. We've got to keep knocking about, look for spaces.
Arnold looking to do just that. Got past his man, but couldn't whip the cross over, which was what he was trying to do. He's won a corner instead, and Robbie Hooker will go across to take it. Graham Arnold has had this Achilles problem that has been nagging him for a couple of years now. Harder grounds in Japan haven't helped his cause at all, and there is speculation that he's coming back to Australia shortly. As Bingley comes in to meet the header, and he does, and it's just past the post. In fact, it was Craig Moore. Very similar in appearance, and it was a good leap from him.
It's a magnificent corner. They're floating it. They're obviously looking for Craig Moore. He's coming from deep and attacking the ball really well and just wide of the post.
Well, we mentioned earlier that Hay is very keen to make his mark here. And that certainly would have done it. There he is, winning it in the air again. Nicely for just a moment there with Olivia Dexter. Australia win the ball back very quickly. Tahitian struggling somewhat with the climate here in Australia. You see them training during the week with gloves on and tracksuit bottoms on days that most of the Australians would have just t-shirts. Hooker, Trimboli, not a lot he could do with that. Straight to him, but right to his head. Tahiti hacked the ball away for a throw. 52 and a half minutes gone here. No matter. Australia 1, Tahiti 0. Here's Moore. Ball chipped in. Arnold's there. Hooker's underneath it. Can't win it. And he keeps it in. Back to Zelic. Still Zelic. A lot of pressure on the ball there coming from the number seven. Hold up. Trimboli. First time layoff. Oh, Vidmar almost stole it. Chance here for Australia. Zelic took the shot. Again, an opportunity gifted to Australia by the defence. The ball wasn't cleared properly. And Zelic had the opportunity to take the shot, which he did.
As we see the throw-in, good ball back by Paul Trimboli, the defence all over the place. And then Zelic, unfortunately, didn't hit it as sweetly as he would have liked.
Again from Tahiti, who are not backing off by any stretch of the imagination. They're prepared to push on to the Australians when they're in possession, and they're rewarded with some possession of their own as a result of that. Just kept in. Came over, easy for Kalas. No one in there for Tahiti, but just occasionally they do manage to string a few passes together, which will worry Terry Venables just a bit. He was very keen to keep Australia applying the pressure on the opponents on Wednesday night. He'll be looking for more of the same tonight, but it's a totally different game so far.
Well, as the game progresses, you'll find if the scoreline stays the way it is, that the Tahitians will get a little bit more confident. They'll start playing some more balls around, playing some more 1-2s. Again, we're trying to penetrate straight through the middle and trying to play some difficult balls. I think it's important that Socceroos start getting out wide, getting the players overlapping a lot more, and there's got to be a little bit more movement. At this point in time, you see both Matthew Bingley and also Robbie Hooker acting as wingers, and I think maybe they should be getting a little bit more involved in the game, more in the midfield of the game, and start breaking from deep. At the moment, what they're doing, they're actually sitting way forward. Here's Robbie Hooker as an example. And he's getting the ball, he's trying to get back in, and I think it's important that he gets a little bit wider.
Free kick to Australia, taken quickly. Zelich thought about the shot himself, but decided to spray it wide. Bingley. Well, outnumbered there 2-1, Matt Bingley, and the moment was lost somewhat for Australia. And Tahiti managed to just bottle him up over there. Craig Bull was going outside him looking for some space out wide, but cross didn't come for Australia. Musket. Kenneth wasn't expecting that. Musket fairly firmly at him from the short range. Zelich finds some space with a lovely bit of skill. Trimboli goes past his man. Hooker. Musket. Nice build-up from Australia. They need a good cross to come. It's come from Musket here. Lay back. Vidmar. Deflection. Corner. Another example of some fine build-up play from Australia.
You see the ball coming in from Kevin Musket. Fortunately, Graham Arnold couldn't attack the ball, but he did exceptionally well to lay it back. And a good strike by Aurelio.
Short corner, cross whipped over, dealt with by the defence. Bingley with the throw. Trimboli. Ball in. Arnold's in there. The defence got there just before him. They're forced to concede the corner. Seven and a half minutes gone at Parramatta as Hooker whips across the corner. And Tahiti deal with it again. And that has been the story very much of the first half. And a vastly different game from 2 days ago. Hooker winning it back for Australia. Zelich in total command in midfield for Australia, but they really are struggling somewhat to break down this quite compact Tahiti defence. The defence that has been trouble with the loss of their goalkeeper already, and there's a 19-year-old now in goal for Tahiti. It's an Australian ball. Still 1-0 to Australia. Vidmar, given away a little bit cheaply. Free kick to Tahiti, and they can feel well pleased with their opening 28 and a half minutes. Tahiti containing Australia, limiting Australia's shots and chances on goal.
Well, I think they're playing the game, which is going to create a lot of problems for the Socceroos at this point in time. A lot of the players seem to be getting frustrated because the opportunities aren't there to be able to play the ball around as freely, and the movement isn't the same as the other night. Again, we're talking about the opposition. Tahiti here are playing between 9 to 10 players behind the ball, and they're not really creating too many gaps for the Socceroos. Great ball back.
Great ball by Arnie.
Graham Arnold.
Hooker coming in. Whipped it across. Just taken off the head of Paul Trimboli by the recovering defender there, Harold Amaru. But Graham Arnold did superbly to get the ball back to Robbie Hooker here. He got past his man and whipped in a good cross. And Paul Trimboli, look at this, just waiting to nod it into the back of the net. and a great recovery from Amaru. Corner to Australia. Shot comes in. A wild one from Ennis. Just what's going through Terry Venable's mind now. He's seeing a totally different game. He's required to make some different adjustments to the other night. He went in half-time against the Solomon Islands with a four-goal advantage. And really, he just wanted more quality in terms of the ball played into the penalty area. But there's a bit more work for him to do tonight, Charlie.
Most certainly. I think if you have a look at the way the Socceroos have started, I don't think he'd be too disappointed. The fact that the boys still realise that, you know, they've got to settle in a little bit. As we see an injury, there's a man down there, and it looks like Graham Arnold to me.
I didn't see how he went down, but he doesn't look in good shape. And I noticed the Australian bench was up very quickly when he did go down. He just landed awkwardly on his back, I think. That was the main problem there.
Looked a rather nasty land as well. He just sensed the pain. Oh, he's a tough character. I'm sure he'll get up. Take a bit more than that, perhaps, to get him off. He's so keen to do well. Graham Arnold. Just winded, perhaps. Walking off of his own accord. Don't think that's the last we've seen of him tonight.
Arnold, now 33 years of age, playing in Japan with Eddie Thompson, Sanpeche, Hiroshima. Talking to him the other day about his life in Japan, it's totally different from Europe. The language problem is a problem. They have to get someone in once a month just to organise all their bills because it's too hard for them to work it out themselves with the different character set of the language, not to mention the spoken side of things as well. I think that sort of comment fuels speculation that he'll be returning to Australia, perhaps for the start of the next era cup season. Moore comes forward. Arnold, here he is. That's back to Bingley, cross to the far post. Hooker's there, a couple of Australians, one was Ennis. Two goes down after a heavy landing. But perhaps a little bit more encouragement there. They did work the ball wide, Australia. Arnold helped it back to Bingley, who got the cross in. And Ennish couldn't direct the header. There's a grimace too about the aiming from him. Still 1-0 to Australia. Now wins it back. Here's Hooker.
Well, it's amazing how quickly Tahitian players all get behind the ball and behind that semicircle effectively. And I think the Socceroos just have to keep playing the ball around and trying to draw them out. Here we see nearly all 10 players and the goalkeeper behind the ball. And they're forcing the Socceroos into trying to play very difficult balls into the box. And that's the reason why we don't probably see as many opportunities in the game. So,
thoughtful Terry Venables.
I think Terry Venables would have liked a few more goals up his sleeve at this point in time. But as I was talking about earlier, the Socceroos will take a little bit of time to settle down, and I think you'll probably see the pace in the second half will be completely different.
It is a full squad rotation virtually for this team on the park now. Not easy to just come in and adapt to your teammates around you. Five Australian based players, six European based players in the 11. Having said that, we would have had their money on Australia having more than one goal by the 34th minute, which is the situation here. Zelic trying to make the Tahitian defence adjust with switching of the play. Good ball inside. Trimboli back to Ennis. Flipped over. No one there for Australia. Hooker will pick the ball up.
Well, that's exactly what the Tahitians are looking at. getting the Socceroos to play balls from deep where the defenders can go goal side and actually attack the ball. It's important that they're patient. Again, we see all the Tahitians behind the ball. They're literally sitting on the penalty spot. And there's so many players there, it makes it so difficult for the Socceroos.
Jimboli got past one, waiting for some movement. Too tight in there, really. It fell, though, fortunately, to Matt Bingley.
But it was a fortuitous chance, really, created for Australia. It was no room to manoeuvre through the centre there, but it just popped off a defender and it fell to the feet of Matt Bingley. Another corner to Australia. Hooker takes it. Goalkeeper comes. Punches. Good punch from the young 19-year-old. He gets the support of the decision from the referee as well.
Jimmy Takotina plays for AS Juventus.
Australian bench. Jimmy Tapai in the front. From left to right at the back, Jason Petkovic. Sam Azaridis and Tony Vidmar.
Petrovic in particular will be keen to see some time and action. The other three all played the other night. That's a fine ball. Muscat recovering. Won't get there in time. Duepede did well to get there, but then didn't go any further with it. The second yellow card of the game to the number 17, Harold Amoru.
Great little touch inside. Enes forward. Good ball from him. Arnold. Phil Arnold got past his man. The shot comes in. Great try. G. Graham Arnold looked hungry for a goal there. And it was a good move as well, particularly Trimboli and Enes's involvement. Great ball there from Enes.
What a magnificent move. Great vision by Graham Arnold. He struck the ball well. Unfortunately, just wide. As we can see, they're breaking forward again. Robbie Enes playing it through. This is a great skill, great nutmeg by Graham. Looks up exceptionally well. Played it in the right angle. Again, unfortunately, just missed the target.
The ball played across the goal there by Graham Arnold was a little bit like the one that he scored from against New Zealand in 93 when Carl Viet played a ball like that across to the far post. Arnold came in and scored. Australia beat the Kiwis 1-0. Time he was hoping for a teammate to finish it off. Kevin Muscat, Hooker, Muscat. This is good play again by Australia. Early cross off the left foot. Clearance. Enes put in there quickly, trying to start again for Australia, and he's fouled. Not a lot of Australian players in the penalty area as Ned Delic waits to take the free kick. Bingley's now making his way in. Good header there, just over from Arnold. Well, twice in the last 2 minutes, Graham Arnold has shown us what he can do.
Paul, what a great floated ball by Ned Zalich. Graham Arnold got up well just over the bar.
Again. Matt Bingley in that wide position hasn't been involved as we've seen him in certainly the Four Nations where he was a major focal part of Australia going forward.
The situation he had for most of the players seems to be quite static.
and they're waiting for the ball, and there doesn't seem to be enough movement in the attacking third. As we saw again the other night, how there were so many changes that it took a place, and players were playing all over the field. At this point in time, you're finding Matthew Bingley sitting very much on that right touchline, and Robbie Hooker on the left-hand side, and they're not really creating the opportunities where they're getting behind the defence and getting to the byline to get the ball back. Hooker with the corner. Moore working his way in. Arnold there as well. Again, the goalkeeper did the job required. NS trying to whip it in. Vidmar just whipped off his toes by the defence. Again, Paul, we're seeing the ball being played right in the middle where there's so many players, and it's going to be very, very hard to try to penetrate through there. It's important that they get wide. Again, look at the amount of people that we see inside that 18-yard box, and they're trying to play. Trimboli, brilliant turn. Moore still there. Bingley in attack and support as well, but his cross is blocked. So many bodies behind the ball from a Tahitian perspective, and now they've won the ball here. But Craig Moore quickly recovered. Inish. Zelich calmly out to Moore. Australia begin again with this quandary of how to overcome so many numbers in defence. Vidmar wins it in the air. Well, interesting there. That was deemed to be a back pass by the referee. An interesting decision there, because the rule states that it is the intention of the defender that is in question. And now, did that defender intend to pass it back to his goalkeeper? Let's take another look here.
I don't think he even knew that the goalkeeper was behind him.
I don't think he did either. What was his intention? That is the ruling. And the ruling from Mr. Precious from New Zealand was that it was an intended back pass, and Australia have one of these awkward little indirect free kicks close to the goal. They look a great opportunity to score, but so often teams miss chances like this. Now, Aurelio Vidmar and Arnold, the two veterans over the ball. Arnie wants to hit it into the wall. And offside, chance wasted.
Paul, you don't see too many goals being scored by players that are that close to the goal. I remember when we were playing with Frank Arrows as coach, we used to always defend those, and we used to put the goalkeeper in front of the wall, actually, on most instances, and not too many teams actually score from there.
Looks harder than what it is, and Richard Van Son there, the Tahitian coach, he'll be well pleased with the side's performance in this first half. We've got a couple of minutes to go before the break, and they're still just a goal down. Jelko Kalap with a touch. That is a reflection on the game. He's hardly been in the game, even less so probably than Mark Bosnich the other night. But at the other end, Australia haven't created as many openings. Power up. The Tahitian number three. Free kick to the Socceroos. Foul there by Vachon. Trying to take it quickly with Paul Trimboli, always aware, always thinking. Now the ball comes over. No one really ready for it. Musket. And he got the ball back. Vidmar. Arnold there, trying to nod it back for Trimboli. Trimboli picks it up. A little chip to the back post. Aurelio Vidmar across. Surely a second it is. Paul Trimboli was the Johnny on the spot, if you like, for the perfectly pulled back ball from Aurelio Vidmar. It's Trimboli's sixth goal for his country. And they don't come any easier than that. Aurelio Vidmar involved once again in front of goal for Australia.
As you see, Matthew Bingley playing a ball. Farther defence got caught. Caught square. Aurelio Vidmar back, and Trimboli an easy tap in.
Graham Arnold waiting just behind him if Trimboli hadn't been there. But Trimboli involved at the early part of the move with that ball to Bingley, so he deserved to get something from it. The defence couldn't handle it. The goalkeeper was taken out of the equation. Trimboli makes it two.
Paul, that's a very crucial goal just before half time as well. I think Tahitians have been playing exceptionally well. They've had a lot of players behind the ball and they've made it very, very hard for the Socceroos to create easy opportunities. As you see, Nedzelic break forward, trying to combine with Paul Cimboli. And I think that's important that we start breaking forward a lot more.
Bingley whipping in across. Australia still on the front foot. Hooker at the back post. The goalkeeper's beaten. Arnold was waiting. Zelic on the volley. Well hit. But the goalie this time gets two hands on the ball. And there was just a bit more zip about that move for Australia. It's something perhaps that second goal has provided some kind of spark as the number nine for Tahiti comes back onto the park. The captain, Lysant. Milan Ivanovic has hardly ventured forward from the back. Just wonder if that's part of the set of instructions from Terry Venables. So many players dying to get forward.
Well, I feel that you've got to be careful that they don't all try to get forward and get caught on a counter-attack. So even here we see nine Socceroos forward. The ball played to the far post again. And Milan Ivanovic has caught one-on-one at the back, so if they play a real long ball, he may even get caught out. So it's important that they start to take shape. But I feel the Tahitians, whilst they're playing a very much a defensive game, it's one of the hardest games to try to play. And if they try to do this in the second half, you'll find that there's going to be a few more gaps opening up and the Socceroos will start to get behind them. I think that if they want to put more pressure on the Socceroos, what they have to do is try to keep more possession and start believing in themselves rather than getting rid of the ball after one or two passes.
We're almost 2 minutes into time added on here at Parramatta. Have been some injuries in the first half. Zelic, that little cutback of his that sees him gain 2 or 3 yards on an opponent. Cimboli, awfully deep. Vidmar pushed into his space. Great ball from Cimboli to Arnold. Now he needs some support. Arnold tried to get past his man, but it was some quick work from the goalkeeper off his line. As Arnold looked to the referee for some assistance there.
And what a magnificent ball. We know about Paul Cimboli and the way he plays and his vision. Great turn by Graham Arnold. He was held back there for sure. I mean, the way I saw that was clear. It was definitely a penalty. He was definitely held back. A little bit unlucky there.
So far, nothing for Graham Arnold in front of goal. A little unlucky. That was another example of that. Zelic takes over. We're almost 4 minutes into time added on. Is there another one before half time for Australia? Zelic. Hooker. Good ball in. Arnold waiting. Nodded down to Vidmar. A lovely back heel. Good idea from Aurelio Vidmar, but well anticipated there by Dexter of Tahiti. Musket. And he provides just one great pass to a third goal for Australia. Arnold! What a goal! Surely over the line. Not according to the linesman. Well, such a direct move from Australia. It was so quick.
Kevin Musker playing a magnificent ball. What a great ball by Paul Cimboli and Graham Arnold. And the defender. And that looked very, very close. We see it again. A good ball played in. Great touch. A great shot. And Jesus, not much
hard
in that
call.
At all. Not
hard
much
call.
In that at all.
We can look at that several times on replay and still not be any clearer. Enish. Moore. Oh, well into 5 minutes of extra time. Cimboli, great goal. What a great strike that was from Paul Trimboli, his second goal of the game. It's almost as though the referee was waiting for Australia to just finish another goal before half time. We are 6 minutes into extra time.
Well, I was talking about the build-up and the movement of players, and what we find, Craig Moore ended up getting wide by Matthew Bingley coming into the middle, and great touch and great shot by Paul Trimboli. As you see, Craig Moore venturing forward on the right-hand side again. Matthew Bingley created the opening there for him. A great ball
here at the Parramatta Stadium. The captain's armband has been transferred from Aurelio Vidmar to Graham Arnold. Vidmar has been substituted, and the replacement player is Chris Trajanovski, who recently signed for Adelaide City. Graham Arnold will lead the side in the second half. Trajanovski looks like he'll play in that role behind the front two, Charlie.
Yeah, I think so. And it's good to see Graham Arnold with that armband. I know that at the time that I was moving on, I think he was one of those people that were talked about as taking over that role, and then he moved to go overseas. So you'll see, Graham loves the challenge, and he's a natural leader. So there are so many players that are vying for that position.
Trajanovski, an immediate impact. Arnold through. It looks like a four. It is a four. Finally, Arnold gets one, and he's deserved one for sure. But the impact of the substitute, Chris Trajanovski, cannot be overlooked. It's something about the armband that sees you find the back of the net for Australia.
Well, I just wish I could have scored so many. Nah, but what a great start for the Socceroos. You see, Chris Trajanovski, the ball was won a little bit earlier on. Looked up, played a magnificent ball for Graham Arnold. And look at the amount of composure. Absolute magnificent finish.
That's Graham Arnold's 18th goal for his country.
And that's where the ball was won. A great little counter-attack. Great little ball across by Chris Trajanovski. And a quality finish.
Well, if Tahiti came out in the second half hoping that the Australians might slacken off the pace somewhat, they'd be disappointed. Tremendous start there from both Trajanovski and Arnold. Cleared away by Lou Divion. Look up. Lydia Vidmar taken off at half-time. That was a little bit of a surprise. There was much conjecture in the commentary box over just which player would make way for Chris Trajanovski, who was told during the break that he would be coming on.
Well, I wouldn't read too much into it. I think Terry Venables knows exactly the quality of play that Lydia Vidmar is, and if anything, he might have had a slight little nagging injury or something. As you see Tahiti venture forward, they appear a hell of a lot more confident. But again, on Aurelio Vidmar, he's a quality player, and I think Terry Venables said that he was going to try to give as many players the opportunity as possible under these circumstances. And true to that, he's put on Chris Trajanovski.
Well, just looking at the bench, there's also David Drilich and Josip Skoko, who haven't seen any time so far. Also, there is Ernie Tapai, probably a little bit unlucky not to get a start tonight, Ernie Tapai. He came on as a substitute against the Solomon Islands and really took over the game, if you like. He's on the bench again tonight, and Arnold works his way down the right-hand side. Good cross to the back post. Trajanovski's there. Hooker will pick up the loose ball. He waits for it to go out. Taken quickly. Trimboli. Little ball to Musket. Trimboli, former South Melbourne teammate. Mishit volley from Enish, and Tahiti will come away with the ball, but not for long. Moore in very quickly. Bingley got there but couldn't keep the ball.
Well, there's certainly a lot more purpose by the Socceroos at this point in time. They seem very sharp. They're closing down the Tahitian players a lot quicker. They're knocking the ball around. There's certainly a lot more movement off the ball. As we see Robbie Hooker coming in more into the midfield, the middle of the park, opening up that flank. And it's important that there is a lot of that movement.
Ball given away by Tahiti. Ivanovic, well played. Zelic takes over. Is Matt Bingley. Going outside him is Craig Moore. What difference will the half-time talk of Venables make? Little ball to the back post. Arnold was coming in there, just needed a little bit of help for the ball to reach him. Tahiti come away. Ball inside. But they can't seem to maintain possession for long. Then Arnold with a great touch out wide. Hooker joining in down the left. Ball across to Trimboli. Too much height in the defence for Paul Trimboli. Australia begin again. Just under 5 minutes into the second half. If you've just joined us, Australia got off to a flying start just after the break with a great goal from Graham Arnold. Hooker won't get there. Ball running through to the young goalkeeper. Tahutini. Who's seen the possibility of him playing in the Premier League in England next season with Crystal Palace winning promotion after that 1-0 victory over Sheffield United in the playoff at Wembley. It was a remarkable rise for him if that sees him involved at Palace next season in the English Premier League. Just last season he was playing for South Melbourne. It's amazing what a short time 12 months is in the game of football. Moore down the line. There is Kevin Muscat. Hooker. Zelic. Tahiti with 10 men behind the ball. Zelic gave it away very easily indeed. Kalas, who the same problem that Martin Bosnich had the other night in keeping his concentration up and his interest up in the game. He's such a character, he likes to be involved in the game even though it means he's under pressure. Enesh. Big leap. Deep cross. The goalkeeper's there. Easy save for him though. He did make a bit of a meal of it, the Tahitian goalkeeper there. Just slapping it away for a corner. Hooker across to take it. Everyone back for Tahiti bar. Their one striker, Duepede. Taken short. Muscat. Plenty of yellow shirts in the centre. Arnold at the back post. Moore was there as well, and it went over the top of all of them. Interesting stage of the game, Charlie. Australia were 4-0 up on Wednesday night at halftime, and they're now 4-0 up here. And of course, we saw on Wednesday the Solomon Islands just fall apart when the player got sent off, but you get the impression that it won't be as easy in this second half as it was the other night.
Yeah, Paul, unless something unusual occurs, you find that the Tahitian players seem to be a lot more composed. The team effort and the team spirit seems to be a little bit different. They're not getting caught square at the back. Admittedly, they are sitting way back, but there's no way that they can get caught square. But I still feel that what they do wrong is that they're playing the ball after they get possession. They're just losing it. They don't seem to be confident on the ball. And it is a bit of a shame because, you know, when they do start knocking the ball around a little bit, you find that, you know, they have got a little bit of skill and, you know, they can string, you know, four or five passes together. But unfortunately, the final one seems to be the wasted one.
Oh, loose ball here. Trimboli's offside. Well, he's going in search of his hat-trick, Paul Trimboli, and you can understand how hungry he is in front of goal. It's a chance for players in matches like this to boost their international tally. Just ask Damien Murray and John Aloisi after five goals apiece from them the other night. But Trimboli was just beaten there by the offside flag.
here's the situation that I was talking about where the ball just kicked away by the young keeper for absolutely nothing. We've seen that happen on too many occasions, and I think the coach wouldn't be too happy.
There is the coach, Richard Bassam, who was coach of Tahiti 18 years ago, but has been out of the picture for such a long time, of course, but there's a new regime taken over football in Tahiti just 3 weeks ago, in fact, when the administration and coaching staff was changed completely. Richard Vincent was reinstated as coach. Didn't have much time to prepare, but he looks like he's certainly organized his side very well in the short space of time that he's had. Trimboli bundled over there by the number 17, Amaru. He'll have to watch out. He's already been booked once. It was a blatant foul. And he's treading on thin ice. Harold Amaru. Zelic. Zelic again. High ball in. Still Tahiti dealing with most of the Australian attempts. Finish. Long ball. Easy ball for the goalkeeper.
Well, I don't think there's any real need for, you know, balls like that from right in the middle of the park. The keeper and the defenders absolutely adore and love those type of things. And, you know, the Australian team's been playing quite well. I think all they need to do is just keep possession, keep the ball on the ground. I think that'll frustrate the Tahitians even more. And just try to get them out of position and try to get behind them as much as possible. I think that's where the majority of the opportunities will be created. And they'll be the easier opportunities too to finish. And I think the strikers really look forward to those. And here we are, there's another long ball. I'm sure Terry Venables wouldn't be too happy about those long, hopeful balls.
Possession given away a little bit cheaply from an Australian perspective, and Terry Venables puts the cross at his bench. Perhaps some changes, more changes in the wind for Australia. Certainly plenty of options for him on the bench, and we'll take a look at his substitutes. Tony Vidmar, David Drilich, Ernie Tapai, Josip Skoko. Jason Petkovic, the goalkeeper. I can't see him getting a run somehow. Sam Lazaridis. All fairly attack-minded players and could make an impact in a game like this.
Well, I feel like the other night as well that Terry Venables is going to give the players on the park as much opportunity as possible to perform. I think the fact that he did make those nine changes from the last lineup goes to show that he believes in the players and the players in the squad. You see another great build-up.
Trimboli taking over. Ennis still there. Tahiti get the ball away.
Again, very congested. And they're trying to play it a little bit too simple in the middle of the park. But as I was saying, I think Terry Venables will give the players on the park as much opportunity. If anything, we might see one or two substitutions. I know the players are going out there now and warming up. But I think if he is to make a change, he'll be making a change, and he want to make sure that the players are ready to go on the park. That's why he's got them all out there warming up at the moment.
Zelic can't get there. Tahiti come away. Bowen, nice ball from him. Help gone, good ball as well. Due Pere working his way down the right. First real moment for Tahiti in attack in this second half, but it didn't last too long. Due Pere, who's making his debut tonight. Trimboli brought the ball down well, but his pass somewhat undersold. Well, the NS who had to foul his man. The momentum that was gained so early in the second half after Chris Trajanovski put Graham Arnold in has been lost somewhat in the last few minutes. Ennis, well, he played the ball there, Robbie Ennis, though it was a tackle from behind. But technically, the referee was correct.
Arnold takes over. Man free down the left. It's a good ball to find him. Robbie Hooker with the cross. Loose ball. The goalkeeper's missed it. Trimboli couldn't get there. Tahiti keep the ball in and play on. Paul Trimboli, who's two goals late in the first half, made the scoreline a lot more respectable for the Australians at half-time. Musket. Arnold. He can come away with Alda. Duatere. Again, Australia win the ball back awfully quickly. So often, Charlie, we see in European match statistics of possession in game, and I'd say Australia would have something like 85 to 90% of possession here. But four goals to show for that amount of possession is probably not a good return.
Well, I think at the end of the day, it's the result that counts, and I think the important thing for the Socceroos is the way they're actually playing and keeping possession of the ball. Whilst they've had a lot of possession, they may not have created as many opportunities as the previous game, but I think, in all fairness and credit to the Tahitians as well, they're not giving the Socceroos as many opportunities. We haven't seen many times where the Socceroos have been able to get behind the defence, and it was only just a couple of minutes ago where we saw a break down the left with Graham Arnold playing a good ball through and across with Trimboli. So we actually did get behind them, apart from that first goal that Paul Trimboli scored, where really Avidma got behind. But very rarely are they getting those opportunities. And Tahiti's actually making it a lot easier. Here we go, again, they've lost possession. With Craig Moore. And they're making it a lot easier, so the Australian players don't have to actually chase hustle and bustle.
Okay, gave the ball away, but Australia win it back quickly. Inesh. Also finding his man with the pass. Left on, Trimboli and Arnold. Ball bounced between them. Ivanovic wins it. Out briefly for Tahiti. Again, Australia begin. Ned Zelic hasn't been quite as prominent in the second half as he was in the first. Duapere, Enes, just too quick for him.
Well, Tahiti's always going to find it hard to break because there's so many players that are sitting so far back that when they do win possession, they've got a lot of ground to make to try to even get anywhere near having an attempt at goal. And here we go again. We're trying to play a little bit too smart sometimes, and it's not coming off. I think it's important that the players just get back to the basics. As Paul Trimboli, I think, realises that was going to be a very difficult ball to try to play over the top of the defence, so close to the goal. All they need to do, I think, is just keep possession, keep playing the ball around, and that'll frustrate the Tahitians even more.
And Tahiti have decided to make a change. It's the number 10, Russo, who comes on for Duepere. Russo, one of the few players that played here in November, and he also played against Australia in the 1993 World Cup qualifiers. He's the only Tahitian player in the squad who is still around from 4 years ago. Australia have got far more than that, and that is a rough tackle indeed on Arnold from the number 14, Olivier Dexter. What will the referee decide to do here? Well, no yellow card. Dexter claiming that Arnold was using the elbow. Don't have to be an expert or a genius to work out what his body language was saying to the referee. Australia have the free kick regardless. There are six yellow shirts in the middle. Moore is one. Loose ball. Brought down nicely on the edge of the penalty area there by the substitute. Free kick to Tahiti. Well, talking to some of the Tahitians during the week, they feel that they are a match for Australia technically, but have plenty of ground to make up
in the area of fitness and tactics, just all-round know-how of the game. But
well, did I hear that correctly? Did you say technically?
Technically, they feel they're a match for the Australians.
Well, unfortunately, it's not showing and it's not represented here on the park. You see how many times that individual players may have certain amount of skill, but I don't think as a unit they're not combining at all. And they're giving the ball away very easily. I think this is probably one of the easiest games Socceroos have had to play from a defensive point of view, or trying to close down play, because they're getting the possession very quickly and very easily and very cheaply. So I'd love to be playing in a game like this where you didn't have to chase to get possession of the ball. It just seems to be, in many occasions, just knocked forward or knocked long or knocked out. And I'm sure that a lot of the players, like even in that situation, we had three of the Socceroos putting pressure on one player.
Well, Zelko Kalats hasn't been involved much tonight, so he's got to make the most of any moments when he does get the ball. He's very competent with the ball at his feet. Just taking on his man there. In fact, if Australia got a penalty tonight, he would be equally capable of taking it as was Mark Bosnich the other night. By white shirt, Paul Trimboli wriggling away. Zelic, Trimboli again, moving it on quickly. Enes, early ball into Arnold. Hooker coming in from the left. Robbie Hooker, good shot, good save from the keeper. Matt Bingley followed up. A fifth goal for Australia. And Bingley, who scored twice in the Four Nations tournament in January, keeps up this little scoring run that he's on for his country. And an easy tap in there for the Marconi defender. Scoreline starting to look just that little bit more respectable now for Australia.
Well, it was good build-up by the Socceroos. You have Graham Arnold and Robbie Ennis. And Robbie Hooker having a straight, great striker goal. And good follow-up with Matt Bingley. As we see again, a good ball laid in. Graham Arnold being upended a little bit. Robbie Hooker coming through. A good strike of goal. A good save by the keeper. But didn't parry it out wide enough. And Matthew Bingley, who I believe throughout this game hasn't probably made the mark as he normally has. In terms of the penetration coming forward. But it's good to see that he's right there when you need him to put the ball in the back of the net.
I think he'll be pleased about that because he hasn't been as involved in this game as we've seen him in previous games for Australia, and that's a nice little confidence booster for him. Trimboli. Australia about to make a couple of substitutions. Moore. Capai and Sam Mazaridis about to come into the game. Got it, long ball. Easy for the goalkeeper. Well, this young keeper has made some good saves tonight, but he could never be blamed for any of the goals that have gone in. That last one, he could have just carried it a little bit further away from Bingley, but his first reaction save to stop the shot, the initial shot that is, was first class. Ennis. Bowley, back to Ennis. Zelic. Moore joining in. Arnold. This is better from Australia. Ennis. Ennis takes the shot himself. Just a little hesitantly. There's Arnold there. Complaining about the decision.
No, it's gone his way. In fact, Tahiti complaining about the decision because it was Paul Trimboli who came in on the defender there. High foot up after the ball was cleared away by Vichon. The foot went into Trimboli's thigh. I think that's a little bit of follow through there. No real malice from the Tahitian defender, but it's a free kick to Australia nonetheless. Arnold quick to jump in and just say, oh, I'm prepared to take this one. The substitutions are still on hold. In fact, now finally it's happening, and it's the two wide men who are coming off, Matt Bingley and Robbie Hooker, to be replaced with Stan Lazaridis down the left and Ernie Tapai, who has a reputation now, you could say, as a player who can come on in a game and quickly adapt to conditions.
He's Paul very much an impact player, as we saw the other night, and hopefully he'll have he'll add a little bit to the game, be able to get wide. Australia in a good position here. Graham Arnold, a good striker of the ball. Hopefully he hits the target, which is very important from this range.
Well, Zelic over the ball, Arnold over the ball, Enish not too far away. Everyone back for Tahiti. It looks like a nine-man wall. Shot was blocked. It almost went in anyway. But an acrobatic save from Tahutini.
It's a great strike. Just comes off the Tahitian defender, and that is a magnificent save. These are the type of attempts at goal that normally go in, deflections, and the keeper very confident holding the ball.
Who was the first player to try and pick up any scraps should the goalkeeper have dropped it, but Ernie Tapai. 20 minutes to go here. Australia with a 5-0 advantage. Tahiti ranked 168th in the world. But they don't play an awful lot of games, which is the problem that Australia have had in the past when they're trying to get their ranking up a bit higher. They need to be constantly playing international football, and friendlies don't count an awful lot when it comes to the ranking either. So these results will be good for Australia, as Lazaridis got behind the defence but just couldn't take the ball with him.
Well, that's something we expect from Stan Lazaridis. He's such a gifted player. Magnificent from coming from deep. He plays magnificent 1-2s with the strikers and gets behind the defenders so easily. Seems to glide past them. And I think that's a feature that we'll see hopefully in the next 20 minutes or so. And that may create a few more opportunities for the strikers. And Ernie Tapper on the other flank. Again, another quick player, very zippy. And a player who's not afraid of taking on the defenders. We see the build-up, Paul Trimboli featuring prominently in a lot of the Socceroos build-ups at this point.
And Lazaridis already involved heavily as a substitute, which is good to see. Here he is again. Little ball inside for Trajanovski, not expecting it. Australia have used 3 substitutions. The maximum allowed in a World Cup game. Tapai in plenty of space. Always prepared to run at his man. Zelic, Enish, Arnold waiting at the back post with his arm up, calling for it. Now he gets it. Not a lot he could do with that type of ball anyway, even though he had come short. It really, he was hoping for an early ball to the back post.
Well, I think the Socceroos have to be patient. There's no point playing balls, cheap balls in like that. There's not much a striker can do from that position apart from try to head it back down to a fellow player coming forward. But at this point in time, I think Terry Venables would appear to be quite happy with the way the Socceroos have played. They haven't really given anything away defensively, which is what you'd probably expect in a game like this. I think the closest Tahiti came to scoring would have been Zelko Kalax, who was there by himself, and if he had slipped over or something, then you might have seen a goal. But at this point in time, very composed. Milan Ivanovic has taken complete control, and whilst he may not be totally involved in the game in penetration, as we see only Tapai breaking forward, putting a deep crossing, but easy for the goalkeeper.
But these are the games that are probably the most difficult for the defenders or the sweepers, because you find a lot of your teammates seem to be going forward, as we see the cross again from Ernie Tapai to the far post. Made very easy for the keeper. As I was saying, these are the games that are the most difficult in terms of the concentration side of it. And Milan Ivanovic has done exceptionally well in that department.
There he is, just helping the ball on, not wanting to join in any forward attacks, unlike Lazaridis, who just loves to gallop down that left flank. Whips in a low cross. Well defended there by Boen. Lazaridis involved again. More space for the pacey winger. And Bowley couldn't take the ball with him, though. Tahiti with 11 men behind the ball for so much of the game. They've been well organised in defence. Sheer weight of numbers has frustrated the Australians somewhat. Tapai pokes it forward. Arnold just trying to help it on to Krajinovski. One back. Jelic. Early ball. Good ball too to find Arnold. Trimboli. Little ball over the top.
As we were talking about the Tahitian just playing the cheap ball away, giving it away, giving away possession. And they're always going to be on the back foot defending. Here's Stan Lazaridis just gliding.
Oh, great ball. Lazaridis carrying on. Trimboli with the deftest of touches here as we take another look.
As I was saying, Paul, Stan Lazaridis likes combining with the strikers. Unfortunately, didn't manage to get on to the end of that one.
But he has already made his mark as a substitute. He has almost sped things up for Australia somewhat. They've looked just a little bit lacking in movement at times, but Lazaridis is a more mobile player perhaps than Robbie Hooker. Different style of player as well. Tapai will run at his man. He doesn't know where to go. Still Tapai. Jelic. Tapai again. Went down. No penalty this time for Ernie Tapai. Trimboli, what can he come up with? Still Trimboli takes it on his own. Worth a try as well from Paul Trimboli. And Australia, who have tried to work the ball close to goal for a lot of the game, Paul Trimboli decided to just lash out from the edge of the penalty area.
Well, great movement, great balance on the ball. Unlucky, just gone wide.
Well, he's still in search of a hat-trick, remember, after those two late goals in the first half. Oh, that's a fine bit of play. Great ball as well from the midfielder. And number 14, Dexter, with that little shimmy and the ball through. Corner to Tahiti. Handful of supporters that they have here have really come to life all of a sudden. Short one taken. Gone back just a little bit too far perhaps, but the idea was okay. Well, that's nice play as well. Tahiti forward, onside. Danger here, no. The flag's gone up. That must have been a very close call, because Vishu appeared to have beaten the offside trap there.
Well, I can't understand when you venture forward like Tahiti have and all of a sudden had an opportunity for a corner, but they didn't have anybody in the penalty box at the time the ball was played, and then they decided to play back nearly to the centre of the park, and I just can't understand that. I think you try to take any opportunity you possibly could to have a go at the Socceroos there.
Good ball from Moore. Lazaridis. Space clipped in. Oh, Luke Paul Arnold, great save that from Tahutini. Well, another example of the great reactions of this goalkeeper.
Stan Lazaridis involved again.
like Chris Trajanovski and Graham Arnold playing a magnificent shot at goal. You see it again, Chris Trajanovski playing it down. Graham Arnold in good position. Great stride at the goal, and what a great save by the keeper.
The chance initially fell to Arnold, perhaps a little fortuitously off the defender, but he certainly made the most of it. Good shot there from Ennis, blocked, but well hit, and Ennis has gone down after taking the shot. Gone out for a goal kick. Trimboli goes over to check with Ennis. Ball in the stomach after he took the shot there, and back at him very quickly indeed. Just over 10 minutes to go here. Tahiti can be very well pleased with their nice work. Tapai in quickly. Oh, great play. Still Tapai going. Well, he's been pushed to the ground, and that is a free kick, but a nice little wall pass there between Tapai and Trimboli. It always appeared to be that the defender would get there quicker, but Divion found his man. Tapai went rolling to the ground, and a good opportunity for Australia from the set piece. Again, everyone back for Tahiti. Only four yellow shirts in the middle. Ball to the back post. One in the air. Ten minutes to go here. Five goal buffer. And the Redis. Ball there from Amaru. Just some pressure from Tapai. He's so willing to do the hard work, or the dirty work if you like, and it was too much for Bo in there. He covers more ground in 90 minutes than most players can cover in two games, and with just 20 minutes to play in a game, as he's come on as a substitute, he's got energy to burn.
Paul is certainly the type of player you'd like to have in your squad. He's very mobile, and that's what you need. He's a player who's not afraid to take on defenders, get involved, wants the ball, very nippy, and he can play in several positions on the park, and I think that's important in terms of preparation for this World Cup. Again, we see the Socceroos patient, playing the ball around, keeping possession.
Tahiti look to make a change as well shortly. The ball goes out, surrounded by players very quickly. Zelic doing some pressure there on the number 15, Bowen, and it's another debutant for Tahiti. The Fatapua is about to come on for the number 17, Amaru. Fatapua, just 21 years of age. Plays for AS Venus in Tahiti. All the clubs in Tahiti are called AS because it stands for the Association Sportive, or the Sports Association. Is there a late flurry for Australia, as there was the other night? Trimboli, awfully deep. Waiting for an opening. Tapai, just the sort of player to provide one. Goes past his man. Whipped in a cross, low cross, handled fairly easily by the defence. Zelic. Arnold. Well, that was where the pass was intended, but it was cut out well by number six,
Jean Le Devian. Tackle Tahiti on the break now. Is there something for them in this game? They can be pleased with the scoreline considering what happened to the Solomon Islands the other night. Great play. Lazaridis. Trimboli. Rousseau. Moore will have to go back across for that. Oh, and that's well played by Rousseau. And it was a little unlucky there, Rousseau, because it was 3-1, 4-1 if you count Tapai, who was working his way back. He had an awful lot of work to do, plus Calats to beat after that. He really is a lone ranger.
Most certainly, Paul, and it's very rare that you actually see a player who actually could get the ball from there and actually score. So, and Craig Moore did a magnificent job there.
The Reader's trying to get to the far post. Can't get there. Corner to Australia. We have less than 5 minutes on the clock. It'll be another 3 points in the bag for Terry Venables. There's no denying that. Lazaridis waits for some movement. Goalkeeper again. He probably is now quite enjoying himself, the goalkeeper, Jimmy Tahapini. Lazaridis getting that cross in.
Paul, he's done exceptionally well under the circumstances, coming in and playing against the Socceroos. And he's performed exceptionally well. A couple of the saves that he's made have been world-class saves.
Yes, he hasn't appeared overawed by the occasion at all, which is a credit to his temperament. Trimboli tries to whip in across. Arnold was waiting, all on his own and unmarked as well. Ball didn't find him though. Kevin Muscat. Here's Craig Moore. Two British-based players. Former teammates, of course, in Australia's 1993 World Youth Cup team. So they've been through the ranks together. Muscat and Moore. Arnold there, shaking his head over that decision. Craig Moore. If the scoreline was to remain at 5-0, that would take Australia's goal 4 to 18 in this little three-team tourney. None against. Zelic. Moore, Tapai in space. Ennis wants it forward. Tapai goes past one. Still a couple to beat. Still Tapai working his way into the penalty area. Good ball across. Arnold left it, but left it only for a recovering defender. Moore in quickly. That surely is a foul. Now it is. And the Tahitian bench is up in arms about that decision. But in the end, it was the tackle by Laysan, the captain there. Ennis is staying down.
No.
That first one was tricky, Charlie, to call.
There's no doubt about it at all, Paul. It was certainly a tackle. That was an infringement on Robbie Ennis.
I think it was a tackle just after that one, though, that the referee finally blew up for. Australia's decision at the end either way. Lazaridis, toe poker forward. Still Lazaridis. Great run from him. The cross is just too deep. But the build-up play was first class. Ennis can't take the ball with him. Tapai recovering. Rousseau. Arnold. Ennis rather on the slide. Just a little bit of niggle crit come into the game from nowhere, really. It's been a very fairly played game up to now. Arnold can't get there. Bit of confusion in the Tahitian defence, but they get the ball away finally. Less than a minute on the clock. Is there a late burst from Australia in the second half as there was in the first? Trimboli scored two in the last few minutes. Moore, Arnold calling for it long. Arnold going for it. Well cut out by the defence. Here's Stan Lazaridis. Takes the shot on his own, deflection. Corner. Stan Lazaridis just signed a new three-year contract with West Ham. He's very pleased that he's got that security now. West Ham very pleased with the performance of their Australian. Trimboli takes it. Moore got ahead on the ball but couldn't direct it towards the goal. Several Australians have found their way to West Ham. Craig Moore somehow found his way to Glasgow Rangers after the 1993 World Youth Cup, in which he was so impressive as a 16-year-old for Australia. Again. Ivanovic venturing forward, intervening, getting the ball forward to Lazaridis to take on his man. He whips in another cross. Arnold can't get there. Tapai's coming in. It was a half-hit shot, if you like, but he nipped in front of the defender to try and force the attempt on goal.
Kenny again. Well, it was good to see that he actually broke forward from, instead of staying wide, he's come forward, even though he may not have hit the ball cleanly. He certainly did venture inside the box into a position where he could actually get a chance on goal. There's a lot of good things that have happened tonight. There's a lot of good players. You've seen the player like Ned Zalich, who's in and out of the game, but he hasn't really been needed as much, and he's only done enough to control the game. Craig Moore, I think he's had a strong game. The impact of players like Stan Lazaridis and Ernie Tapai coming on. Robbie Ennis has been involved a lot. And the good thing is you've got strikers like Graham Arnold and Paul Trimboli combining exceptionally well. It's good to see that they've been on the score sheet, and it's certainly a game that was a lot more difficult than the game the other night against the Solomon Islands, and all credit to the players.
They're still in search of goal number six. We move over 2 minutes into time added up. Arnold took the shot on his own. Every right to do so as well at this stage of the game. Going in search of his second goal of the game. A little angry with himself over the attempt. He sliced it somewhat, but it was a difficult angle for Graham Arnold.
Well, I think he was very pleased with the build up there with a nice little back flick to Chris Trajanovski.
The final whistle from the referee, and Australia have come away with the 3 points, as was expected before the game. But what wasn't expected was the stern resistance that has been shown by Tahiti here tonight. They can walk off the ground holding their heads high. A good performance from them to restrict and limit the Australians to 5 goals. Aurelio Widmer, captain for the night, opened the scoring after 17 minutes. And then 2 goals in a few minutes from Paul Trimboli just before the break. 3 at halftime for Australia. An emotional goal for Graham Arnold just after half time. He really has deserved to find the back of the net tonight. And then Matt Bingley with the 5th for Australia in the 66th minute. A great performance from Australia. They march on to play the Solomons next week. The final score here is Australia 5, Tahiti 0. And now we'll cross to Mike Cockrell.
Thank you very much, Paul Williams. Will Perry Crescent.